Hello everyone! Well, my name is Noemi Banky and this is an activity within a huge event because it's 24 hours with my treasure. It means that for 24 hours there will be lectures online, so about metaphysics, of course. This is the topic. And well, we will start now with this activity. Love. All right. So, first of all, I would like to thanks to His Excellency Sir Ruben Cedeño. He is the person who teach me, but also he is my friend, as my father, my guru, all my gratitude to him. But he is now my teacher, but I have others as well. I want to say thanks to them as well. Silvina Saucedo, she in my first steps in this beautiful teaching, she helps me a lot and she is my friend, so, and others as well, so thanks for all of them. And this is the copyrights, because what we are going to say in this video, or this, yeah, because it's online, well, these are not my words. Here I use the Cambridge Dictionary and also the Dolce Supremo by Sir Ruben Cedeño and Daily Meditation by Thomas Prince, Metaphysics by Sir Ruben Cedeño. This book particularly is in Amazon, so if you want to get it, it's for you there. And Pillars of Metaphysics by Sir Ruben Cedeño, Virtudes Divinas by His Majesty Saint Germain, and also we are going to watch a little bit of a movie, X-Men, The Last Stand, directed by Brent Rudner. Okay, I'm talking about love, but first of all, I want to introduce you Lord Maitreya. Who is him? Well, he is the current Earth Buddha, and he is known as well as Divine Lord. He has 8th initiation. He lives in the Tushita heavens, and he is an emanation of Dhyani Bodhisattva Vishwapani and Dhyani Buddha Amoghasiddhi. He works along with Lord Gautama, leading the spiritual hierarchy. This is part of his CV, his resume. I didn't want to put all his information because there would be too much. So I will explain to you now what the last part, when I said he works along with Lord Gautama and leading the spiritual hierarchy. What I mean is that by law of correspondence, the government the in equal form as the spiritual hierarchy. So on the top of this image you can see Lord Gautama. He is now the planetary logos and he is the highest position in the spiritual hierarchy. Underneath is Lord Maitreya, who is now the Earth Buddha. And underneath there are three pictures. Each of them are a department. So we have Vaivasattva, Kuthumi, and Paolo El Veronese. And on the bottom of this image you can see 7 images. Each of them is a Johann. What I mean is a director of a ray. So this is part, a little bit of the spiritual hierarchy. This is not the whole spiritual hierarchy. This is only part of that. So you can understand when I'm saying the Earth Buddha, what does it mean? And remember the words of Nora Belén Vázquez Toledo de Cedeño. She said, We are in metaphysics to believe in what nobody does. Okay, the name Maitreya means love. Okay, and the festival of goodwill is celebrated on the day of the full moon in June, when the forces of the unwrapped inner selves of all humanity become more active and resplendent than any other time of the year. So, actually, we are talking about right now. So, today is the day of full moon of June of 2020. So, this is the festival of goodwill. And the great invocation is a millenary prayer revealed for the age of Aquarius, an instrument of power, the established on earth, the light, the love, and the power of God, the inner self, all the saints, and master of wisdom of the spiritual hierarchy. What I mean is, every full moon is recommend doing this great invocation. This is a universal prayer. It's not belong to any religion. So we can do this all the time if you want, but especially at full moon. So we can start to do now. I will read the title and we can do together. The Great Invocation. From the point of light within the mind of God, let light stream forth into the mind of men. Let light descend on earth. From the point of love within the heart of God, let love stream forth into the hearts of men. May Christ return to earth. From the center where the will of God is known, let purpose guide the little wills of men, the purpose which the masters know and serve. From the center which we call the race of men, let the plan of love and light work out, and may it seal the door where evil dwells. Let light and love and power restore the planet on earth. All right, now, before starting talking about love, I want to say what is a misconception about love? What is not love? Love is not a feeling. And the true love doesn't require any sexual contact. So I'm not talking about movie X XXX. Okay, so we are not talking about this right now. This is not the topic. Okay, and the question is, what is love? Na 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 na. Let's answer this question. Okay, love is the active principle of God. I know, maybe you couldn't understand what love means. So let's see a little more in detail. Because the definition I found in the Cambridge Dictionary about principle and about love, So love is the active principle of God. But what is a principle? It's a fundamental truth. Truth means that always happened as a foundation for behavior. Well, this actually should be. So this is what I'm saying. Your behavior should be founded on love. And I said should because it's not always happened. And God is the supreme being. And when I'm talking about God, there are like, I don't know if type is the correct name, but there are two forms. One is transcendent, another is immanent. God transcend is everywhere. It's like God in everywhere. And God immanent is God within you. And this is called the Christ consciousness. This Christ consciousness is within you. You can see the picture of a lady, a beautiful lady, But not only women has a Christ consciousness. Every single human being. And this inner Christ or Christ consciousness or inner self, it could be named different, with different names. And is the representation, what you are seeing is the representation of the Christ consciousness. Because in metaphysics, we talk about things beyond physics, so things like we cannot see. And if I have to explain a thought, how can I explain to you a thought without an image and you could understand me? It's impossible. The same with the consciousness. Your consciousness is something is not tangible. Okay, so this is only a representation, so it's a way to understand. And there are three aspects the consciousness has: goodwill, wisdom, and love. And each aspect is represented by a color: blue, golden, and pink. So, coming back, what I'm saying is love is within you. And when you want love, you have to go and connect your inner self, your Christ consciousness. Let me tell you something. When I'm saying Christ, don't think about Jesus. I'm not talking about Jesus. I'm talking about your consciousness. Anointed is the adjective that describes this word, Christ. Okay. And here we have two flowers, I would say, because the Christ consciousness is represented as well as a flower, a lotus. And here we have two different flowers. One is closed, and yeah, this is closed, and this is open. This flower is opened. So what's happened? All human being has a Christ consciousness. The thing is, someone has their inner self, like this flower, closed, and as you can see the image here, it's like this person is thinking always about themselves, like for instance me, always me, and they are thinking about my car, my apartment, my family, my work, my always about them. On the other hand, we have this flower. And this flower, because it's open, the direction is outside. And this is the case of person who has developed their inner consciousness or the inner self. And these persons are always thinking about others. So if they see a plant which needs water, they water the plant. If they see an animal which is suffering, they will try to help it. And they are looking at others, so what the others need. And this is the difference between different kind of people. But the love actually is in each human being. And this inner self is here, as you can see the flower here, the lotus, this is the representation of the inner self. And all around we can see 7 spheres, and each of them represents a virtue, which again All this is within the human being, as goodwill, wisdom, love, beauty, health, prosperity, and freedom. So what I'm saying is, as a human being, we have to develop our inner self. And with inner self, all these virtues. And here we have the words of Master Kuzumi. He said, each morning as you meditate on the nature of your presence, oh, let me tell you something, oops. Because I didn't say that this image is the your presence I am. The I am presence, your reality. So this is your presence, oops, here, on the top. In the middle is your inner self, and in the bottom, there is your personality. Okay, three parts. Oops, okay. So, each morning as you meditate on the nature of your presence, the image like you can see you saw before, the power of your presence, the mastery of your presence after contemplating him for a moment. Sorry, I'm not reading. I'm trying to explain to you. When I'm saying him, you don't think like it's a man. Your presence doesn't have any gender. So your presence is not female, neither female nor male. But well, you need to say something. Make a little extra effort and try to be that presence only for half an hour. This is what I ask of those live streams who wish to serve us. When Master Kuzumi says those live streams, don't think about he is talking with someone else. He is talking to you, because you are a live stream. I am a live stream as well. And this is the warning. He says, but be alert to the little worm of a spiritual pride that at the very center of your beautiful spiritual flower wishes to destroy its perfection. And if I'm going, oh God, if I'm going back, okay. What, all these virtues here, tiki tiki tiki, the seven virtues, doesn't work if you don't have love. So the opposite of pride is love. You love your facilitator, you love this teaching, you love the humanity, you love a computer, a glass of water. So if you don't have love, any of all virtues you can have, you can be a wisdom but doesn't work. You can be a healthy person, but it wouldn't work. Also, if you have a lot of money, you're a prosperous person, it wouldn't work. Neither freedom. So love is very, very important to develop. The consciousness of universal love, cohesion, and affection emits electromagnetic radiation of pink light of the inner self. In other words, love. Making the human loves be united, be cohesive with other beings that lives, express, feels, and projects love. Being affective, loving, and grateful for others. So I put again here the image. This is not decoration, okay? This is there so you can understand easier. This is the representation of your inner self, and the pink light is in this side of the image, and it is within you. The electromagnetic ray of pink light of the consciousness of love and cohesion of the inner self is the attraction between the molecules, which holds the particles of our body together. It keeps the body's part united, is the chemistry of the union of different substances and elements in different combinations, which forms all the different types of matter. And I put an example is the water to H2O. This is water. Exactly. What you are looking at is there are love in water. So I show you my glass of water. Here is love. As I said, love is not a feeling. Okay, the electromagnetic ray of pink light of the consciousness of love and cohesion of the inner self is activated and manifest when a person properly communicates the inner teaching and the participants listen to it. And this is what we are doing now. There are one person talking, giving the lecture, and there are other people who are listening to this teaching, because I'm not important. Actually, when I thought to do this activity, I started to think, oh my God, but I'm not sure. And then I said, yeah, well, I can do it. I can do it. And I tried to explain to you what is love. So, here we are. We have a movie. Now we are going to watch a scene with these two beautiful characters, Jean and Wolverine. And I will not. If you want to watch the movie, feel free to do it. But I will talk from the point of view of metaphysics, all right? And Jean, here in this scene, is a student. And she's very powerful. She also developed a huge power with her mind. And, well, on the other hand, we have Wolverine, and he is a facilitator. And I'm talking about metaphysics, okay? The movie is Hollywood, okay. But this is what is like, because you know, an image is worth more than 1,000 words. So I want to show you something instead of talking, okay? I hope you understand the message. And Wolverine, he heals very fast because he had developed his inner self. Any facilitator has the not only the knowledge, because Alejandra, who started this event a few minutes ago from Argentina, she said, the reading is important, but most important thing is the realization of what you are reading. And well, the facilitator, he wants to help her, he wants to help the students. And what's happened with Jean? Well, she can't control her personality, actually her mind. And she became a troublemaker. But stop talking and let's see this scene. The facilitator first called you very gently. And sometimes the students start by ignorance, harm. But he insists. He doesn't give up. He or she, a facilitator, can be a woman as well. Look at her face. Amazing performance of this character, these actors. Oops. Okay, and what is the end of this story? Well, Jean for ignorance, she tries to hurt everyone. But you know, at a point she asks for help. And let me tell you something. If a student is in a metaphysical activity, is because they want to improve. Even though they have a lot of mistakes or a lot of things to work, but they try, so they keep going because they want to improve. So as you see, was only a little bit, so one moment of consciousness. So when the inner self controlled the personality, and she said, "Help me." And this is when the student come to the metaphysical activity. If not, the student, well, will be studying another thing, maybe cooking, doing another thing. And the facilitator doesn't kill you physically. Oh, yeah, sorry. I want to... Don't misunderstand. So nobody kills anyone, okay? So I mean is the facilitator actually work with your... The facilitator doesn't kill you physically, but your ignorance, pride, and hatred with their words to make you be aware of your negativity, all your mistakes. And eventually, her personality dies and the inner self resurrects. When I said look at her face, because always, as I show you in the picture, always there is the personality and the inner self. And if your personality is acting, your inner self is like a flower, is closed. So what I mean is, love is not a feeling. And the facilitator, I think, must love too much to work with someone who wants to hurt them, and even though they still working. And also the student feels like they are going to die. And the point is, well, the personality dies, your thoughts will die. So what you think will die, or what you believe will die. But after that, your inner self will resurrect. And this is all the meaning to you be free of your personality. So there are two types of feelings that stress enormously: fear and hatred. And as I said, a facilitator's always, the student feels like they want to hurt, but not. The point is to be aware of your mistakes. You are afraid of a lot of things, and you have to be aware of that. You hate. When you say, "I hate this carpet, I hate this color," when you use these words, it's because this feeling is within you. So let it be understood. Rancor and resentment. Rancor is the continuing anger about something in the past, something that you did and became in rancor. And resentment, a feeling of anger because you have been forced to accept something that you don't like, are just another form of hatred. But this is not the whole point. So we can say together these words of Archangel Raphael. When you realize all your mistakes, all your hatred, so we can say it together. Lord, forgive me for my transgression of the law of love, and beloved Raphael, consecrate my eyes to see only perfection. If you listen to gossip or discord, if your hands are impatient in gesture and you realize anger, if your lips and tongue use sharp words, say, Lord, forgive me for your misuse of your energy. What if you do have to repeat it? Paderewski didn't become a master musician in one day. The only live streams who are in extreme danger are those who don't wish to pick themselves up, dust off their knees, and try again. And if you think, or if you believe actually that, well, with you is everything is okay, you don't have to forgive yourself, but maybe someone else. And I suggest now thinking about someone who you are not in complete agree. You don't complete agree. And we can say together, I give you my love and my forgiveness to bless you and prosper you. And I will say again this, the second word, give. And this is all the meaning of love. Give. When you give, you are loving. You love, actually. Because this is the meaning of love. And how many times do you have to repeat this decree? Well, remember Paderewski, or well, maybe you don't know Paderewski, maybe think about Luciano Pavarotti. He now is decarnated, but he had to work a lot. So if you want to be good at something, you have to work. So if you want to develop forgiveness, you have to work. Doing this degree. Okay, and every sunset at 6 p.m., Lord Maitreya irradiates his love to everyone who is connected with him. So every day you can connect with love, with my Lord Maitreya. And how? This is the point. Well, I will teach you the conscious breathing. So you can do at 6 p.m., but also you can do any time. And this, I don't need to teach you to breathe, because you already know how to breathe. But this is a specific form, because there are four steps. Is breathing, keep the breathing, breathe out, exhale, and rest. But always through your nose. So breathing, keep, breathe out, and rest. And meanwhile you are doing the steps of breathing, I will doing a decree. Okay? So let's start. I will say, I am love. Okay, so breathe out. I am love. I am love. I am love. I am love. When you breathing, the love is coming within you. When you keep the air in your lungs, means that this love is within you. When you breathe out, this love go through all your body, like the oxygen, through all your body. And when you rest, this love goes up, this love goes out. Okay, one more time. Breathe out. I am the love. I am love. I am love. I am love. And this is all for now. The next activity is with Jorge Asensio in Spain at 3 p.m. in Sydney time. And I don't know in which part of the world you are, but thank you very much for joining this activity. And thank you, Lord, my treasure, for this blessing to be with us for 24 hours. Yeah, have a good day. Bye.